Hello and welcome back to Sweden is Overpowered. Let's continue to maul Norway. And this war is probably going to be over quicker than I want it to be because of the inevitable overextension that I'm going to get. Let's see how much overextension this will result in. 38%. It's going to cost 262 to do that. Well, I guess we're going to survive, you know. Let's move our army down here. Oh, they're actually pulling back even from that. Really? But they're going to stand over there. Well, the Norwegian capital is falling, if it's still here. I guess it is, kind of. I'd like the prestige, thank you. Well, let's go down to Skåne and liberate that from the Danish people. Probably gonna liberate itself anyway because of the fort, but whatever. Okay. Can't really attack over the crossing, but I mean, we can kind of stay here. Have a nice time. They don't have that many ships, but they have more than we do. They have one heavy. Denmark has got one heavy. Nice. That one is really nice. Really good. How much war score do we need to enforce our peace? We are way far away from that. Unfortunately. Well, what we could do, we could always build some ships. Just, you know, we need to start protecting trade anyway. We really do. Denmark doesn't have that much. Oh, they have so many transports there. Interesting. And the heavy is holding that. Well, one heavy and one galley is not really it's not that big of a deal. The other ships will come to the rescue. Definitely. We're gonna have enough diplo to unlock another trade idea, which is another merchant, which I should probably get. Yes, let's get that. And we're gonna start steering trade from Kazan. What the hell was his name? Stan Jägerhorn. That's a really interesting name. Okay, Mr. Rock. Let's build some more. We're not really up to our naval force limit here. So let's continue to build some ships. We should probably recruit a naval officer, an admiral. Just to fight slightly better on the sea. Oh, that one is pretty good as well. Let's collect the navies. Yes. Oh, that's a pretty good one as well. Let's see what happens when we do this. Oh, we just decimated that. Let's help our guys out. we will get a penalty, but they will still lose. Well, because of the cannon and stuff. And we actually won the naval battle. Let's take an inflation hit. It's gonna offset the money we spent for the admiral, which is not bad. You know what I'm thinking? This is what I'm thinking. I really want that. Unfortunately, Norway isn't my rival, so taking territory from them, I guess, is not that big of an achievement or so. But at least we're sieging down some stuff and blockading. I guess we're blockading, right? Yes, blockade percent is 17. Very interesting. Well, it's kind of safe to say that Denmark is not doing very well in this war. Denmark is not a happy camper. And I'm really enjoying it. Because, you know, for reasons, it's always nice to overthrow your overlord and return stronger. Siege is going down. We are going for Muscovy next. But, admin points. Okay, so Denmark, you're probably not going to be very happy right now. Humiliate. Take some money. And war reparations. Definitely going to be happy with throwing Denmark out of the way for extra money. And Norway. Well, you know, could take some extra money from you as well. Some more reparations. How much is that going to increase our inflation? Where does it say that? It's not a lot of inflation. So, we're going with that. Very nice. Now we have a looming disaster. We have units on the way back. We need to core some provinces. We're gonna core almost all of them immediately. Like one more month or so. Oh, his admin skill is really, really low, isn't it? That's kind of an issue right now. In a couple of years, I probably want to switch back to getting admin focus because we're kind of way behind on this. Oh, that's really expensive right now. But, I mean, it's going to spread faster and faster. Not sure paying for it would be ideal right now. We can mothball all forts. Yes. Because, you know, ducats. States want some provinces, so I guess we're gonna give that to them. Clergy. Well, you can get that crappy one as well, again, so don't care about that. This fort setup here is pretty nice. I'm gonna keep that because it protects, it kind of overlaps in this province right here, but then it protects everything. Actually, it protects really well. So I'm just gonna keep that for now. We'll see what we get rid of in the future. But this is really, really good for defensive purposes. Should probably top off this. Poland is topped off already. We should top off Austria. And we should top off England. Our force limit went up by one. Not very impressive either. But that's fine. Would like for it to go up more than one though. Would be really nice. Could use another cannon, I think. Probably gonna run this with 12 to 4. That's gonna make an 18 stack. Feel like that's kind of a nice combo. Not sure how effective it is, but still. We're really close. Can we choose a good rival? Burgundy. I really don't care about Burgundy that much. Let's rival them just to have longtime rivals. We should probably embargo them. Issue embargo. Yes. There we go. Very nice, very nice. We're still stacking up a lot on military tech. And let's take a look at development. That's not development, that's autonomy. Okay, I got confused there for just real quick. Let's get this one up to 10 development. You know, for the Renaissance extra thingamadoo. I don't think we're embracing this quickly enough, but you know, we're getting there. What I wish I could pay for specific provinces to embrace the tech or the way of life or whatever you're supposed to call that anyway. Some cores are coming in. Our looming disaster should not be a problem anymore. National unrest is going down. Let's maintain that diplomat. Trade steering is really good, and then we unlock 5% discipline, which is really strong. Let's consolidate our navies. Can make a state. Let's do that. Now they demand more provinces. This one. Well, we have so much autonomy over here anyway. So I guess that's kind of fine. This one is kind of crappy as well, so we are just going to give that away. Let's see if we can build some more churches for tax. But we don't really have anywhere. That one is 10. I guess that's kind of okay. Not much else going on. We have a coastal center of trade. We should use that at some point, I guess. Let's build a... They already had a marketplace there, so... Let's just save our buckets of ducats for just a bit then. Let's get the barks to go on a mission, protect trade. Baltic Sea. Because that's here, right? Yes. So, I mean, I guess we could kind of go up. Oh, nice. We have another force limit. So, we're definitely going to use that. How many forts do we have? We have 5 forts, so that's 2.5 more ducats. But we're making quite a lot of money right now. What about hiring this guy? I think that's a good choice. We have 1 free merchant now. Didn't I send someone here? I did. I'm pretty sure I remember doing that. Well, I guess I didn't. We can recall that. Wait. What? Why would Ottomans pay Denmark? I don't want trade collapse. Why would Ottomans care about Denmark? I mean, Sweden is glorious, isn't it? Why shouldn't we get more money? I think we definitely deserved more. More of the money. Just, I don't know, grave financial misjudgment, just like the tooltip said. Well, it seems legit. Declining power of the nobility. Okay. Very, very interesting. Our current rating is 187. We're gonna bump up quite a lot once we get the tech cost down. Definitely. We have the same tech cost as Ming right now. I think that is really funny to me. Actually, just Ming is in China. That used to be way different. I guess they have the money to pay for it or something. I'm not really sure how that works. And since I can't see that part of the map, I can't see how tech spread either. But I mean, just look at Renaissance. It has spread so much. And we are kind of... I mean, even Muscovy is way ahead of us. I don't want to take the blame. No. Do not want that stability hit. We're still at zero stability, which is really sucks. Gonna get some more light ships. This fleet, you can just go up here. No, that was an army. This fleet can just go up here because I want to get rid of you so I can easier send ships on missions. I really want to flip over to admin now. We are kind of close to unlocking the last idea, and now we need to start knocking out admin levels instead. It's going to be another year or so before we can change. 14th December of 91. So it's still a bit left. Starting this war now, Poland would join for favors. Are they in a war? They are not. Muscovy, you're in a war with Perm for some godforsaken reason. Now, before we do a huge mistake and attack Muscovy, how strong is Muscovy actually? Muscovy has got 36,000 men. They're out of manpower, which is really good. Lithuania has got 26,000 men with some manpower. Poland. You don't have that much manpower either. But you have another 25,000. I have 23,000, I think. And then another 7 from Novgorod. That's 30. So we should be in a really good position. That's tempting. And then we go for this province here. That's going to be the war goal. Guys, I'm tempted. I am really tempted. We're going to take 4 provinces. The development is kind of high. But the coring cost isn't that bad. It's not that bad. It's actually really low. For the amount of development that we're gonna get, I think it's kind of low. Let's go. What are we waiting for? Really wish this would go away, but doesn't seem like the case. Why are we getting kicked out of this trade node? Let's do that one more time. Now I'm 150% sure that I did this. Sent him out, and then he came back. He should not come back. Can get another military tech. That is cavalry shock plus 0.8. That's nice. That would give us one tech advantage over Novgorod as well. Well, Poland. This is going to be the war goal. We are going to siege stuff down. You can stand on that, actually. Oh, wait. You're not locked in. Now you are. You have 2 cannons, 14 infantry, and 1 cavalry. So they're slightly, they have more infantry. And we get a penalty for some reason. But they lost more than we did. And I'm pretty sure that I have more manpower than they do anyway. Let's take a look here. We have 60,000 cavalry, tw or 63,000 infantry, 12,000 cavalry, 2,000 cannons. So we have double the infantry that they have. But that doesn't mean that we should go crazy with this, because, fighting Muscovy can get really hairy for some reason. We called in Poland with favors. So we called in Sweden with favors, which really means that, or we called in Poland with favors. What the fuck am I saying anyway? Just means that I didn't see what that was. But it means that we don't have to give them anything to make them happy, which makes me happy, because I think it's silly. We should be okay with that. Let's just reinforce, just to be sure. That was kind of dicey, guys. That was definitely kind of dicey. I did not enjoy that at all. Siege of Novgorod is over. We're going to go to Pskov. We just want to, No, just don't do that. Just be careful. Or, well, let's just go there and siege it down. Lithuania is running down, or Poland is running down here. Lithuania is up here. We've got Novgorod as well. And I really want to make sure that I get that province under my own siege. Would suck if that didn't happen. Getting kind of scared. Don't want that one to go here. Oh, we can go there directly. Okay, fine. Good. Just going to protect that. Make sure nothing happens to it. That would be a shame. They're kind of bolstering their forces, though. So we shouldn't. We should definitely not be like, oh, hey, guys, we won the war. Everything is awesome. Reinforce speed. Then we're kind of running on fumes, but it would be nice with the reinforcement speed. 33% would be 10% would be 70. So that would be 200 more a month. I don't think that's gonna make or break this anyway. Oh, now we're in trouble. That's not good. Is that a stack wipe as well? Luckily, it isn't. But that kind of sucked. Oh, but that was nice. Good job. I think we are going to consolidate these. Go back here. That was really good cleanup from Poland, which should put these guys on the back foot. It's kind of annoying that they took back the Orgol. But, you know, it's just kind of annoying. Just go there, siege it down. And then I would like to go there. And then I would like to just go there. Oh, we just go there. I didn't want to get involved in that fight though. But it's apparently it's okay. Somehow my unit survived that encounter, which is kind of weird, but you know, I'm not gonna complain about it. Really just want these, and I can get them now. Is there anything else that I want? I would like a humiliate. I mean, that's not gonna happen. Can I get more reparations? Maybe if I siege that down. I'm just gonna wait until we get this fort and see what we can get. Can we get some money? Maybe that's good enough. Okay, swapping over to admin for sure. And we're getting kicked out of that trade node anyway. So where are we going to? Well, I guess collect from trade here and collect from trade here. Because they're kind of closer, but I don't think it's going to result in that much. Siege of Pskov is over. So we get war reparations. But no money. Which is fine, I guess. Call to arms against Burgundy. Okay. Novgorod wants to become a march. I was planning on doing that anyway. So that seems fine. We have a lot of unrest here, guys. Ton of unrest. It's not gonna be nice if these guys fire. That's for sure. It's a bit much overextension. So our navies are kind of ready. Mission, protect trade, Baltic Sea. Mission, protect trade, Baltic Sea. Very nice, very nice. Well, it's been, again, over 30 minutes already. So, well, Muscovy got slapped, kind of. Before we do anything else, I'm gonna get rid of this fort here. Go away. Need to save some money now. We have kind of too many forts. Anyway, thanks for watching. Have a really nice day, and hope to see you again.